Aloha class, let's get it, number four, quattro, yon, shibon. All right, here, same as always, print it out, work out that problem, take a picture, send it to me, and let's see how you do. Remember, don't look at these solutions until after you've taken on a stab and see where the timing has put you when you're done, okay? This is the best estimate we can do to get you guys ready for this AP exam. All right, let's go. On the axis provided, sketch a slope field for the given differential equation. There's 12 points. A lot of you guys take a lot of time doing part A. So if this was on the actual AP exam this year, I would highly encourage you to do part A last, okay? Because some of you take way too long to do it, all right? So let's go ahead and I'm going to do that part last. So we're going to go straight to part B here so I have enough time. All right, show that any point with initial condition that is along the y-axis where y is greater than 1 creates a relative maximum for its particular solution. Okay, so, okay. Well, the only way that it could create a maximum or is if I had a critical point. And they're telling me that y has to be greater than 1. Well, the only way that that derivative is going to be equal to 0 if y is greater than 1 would be if x had to be 0, because then the derivative would be equal to 0. Right, class? Okay, so that's probably what I had to figure out first. All right, next, I have to somehow show that with this being the situation here, that it's going to be a relative maximum. Well, remember, the second derivative and concavity really helps me in this situation. If this happened to be a critical point and the second derivative was, what would we want the second derivative to be? Concave down, then that critical point would have to be a maximum. So let's go ahead and find the second derivative at this situation and see if I get a negative. And if it does, money in the bags. All right, let's go ahead and find the second derivative, which I'm going to treat that as a product rule, okay? So it'd be negative 2x times the derivative of y minus 1, which would be dy dx, okay? Plus the derivative of negative 2x, which would be negative 2 times y minus 1, okay? And so if we look at this, and if I evaluate the second derivative when x is 0 and y is greater than 1, well, this right here is going to turn into 0, and I would end up with just this, right? And if y is greater than 1, that is always going to be less than 0. And if it's going to be less than 0, that means it's concave down. And if it's concave down and that same situation gives me a critical point, then that bad boy would have to be a relative max, sweetie sweets. Okay, that would probably be worth a good 3 points just for doing that. And remember, this is called the second derivative test when we do the second derivative to tell us whether or not we're dealing with a min or a max. Remember, if that was a little confusing, I better see you at Google Meet. Everybody can get a 4 or 5 on this bad boy. I am truly, truly confident. Now, the question that's been coming up in Google Meets like crazy is when these are the directions. What do we do, everybody at home? Splingy, spling. We just separate the variables, right? That's it. So let's go ahead and separate those variables. Remember, you're going to get a point for just separating these guys. Then remember, we do antiderivatives. That's a natural log, okay? And that's a natural log of something linear. My u would be y minus 1, the derivative of y minus 1, which would be itchy or just 1. So that means I don't have to correct anything, okay? Remember, if that was backwards like 1 minus y, I'd have to put a negative out in front. Okay, or hypothetically, let's say if it was like a 2y minus 1. Ooh, derivative of 2y minus 1 would be 2, and I would have to put a half out front. Remember, we always have to correct. But this one worked out really nicely. This here would just be add a 1 and divide by it, right? Plus C. Oh, snappy daps. A C came up. And since a C came up, I use my initial condition. And I get the natural log of the absolute value of negative 1 equals 0 plus C, which means C is equal to the natural log of 1. And the natural log of 1 is 0. Okay, so C is 0. Okay. Gosh, couldn't get easier than that, right, class? I doubt it's going to be this okay on your exam this year. But this year, we're going to just change it to an exponential, remember? We keep that absolute value, okay? And then we go ahead and we get rid of the absolute value by a little plus or minus, right? And then we add that 1 and we say, would it be the plus or the minus? And it would have to be the minus. It's the only way. I got to plug a 0 in for x and 1 minus 1, which would be 0. So that's my answer right there. Remember, that'd be like worth 4 or 5 points. On my solutions, I'm going to show you pretty soon. It says that that would only be worth 3 points. I don't think so. Okay? We've done all of these problems in class. It's going to be worth definitely more than that. All right, part C. This should scream L hoppy hops. Okay? But remember, it says you're going to use it for that solution we got right there. And f of x in that solution we got was 1 minus e to the negative x squared. So let's make sure we recall that. Now remember, whenever we do limits, our first instinct is to direct sub. And remember, my guess is LHOP is probably coming on this exam. So you always have to split it up, remember. Numerator, denominator. That'd be 1 minus, put a 0 in for that. I get 1 over tangent of 0, which is 0 over 0. Check out hop. Go ahead and hop on that one left footies. Do I have enough room? Probably not. Shootsies. Will that erase just that stuff? Okay, it does. So since I get 0 over 0, I'm going to L hop this bad boy, and I'm going to take the derivative of the top. If I take the derivative of the top, it's going to look like that. But then you take the derivative of your inside, which is a negative 2x. Those two negatives actually would cancel themselves out, right, class? All over the limit as x approaches 0. What's the derivative? Ooh, that's a chain rule, outside, inside. The derivative of tangent is secant squared. Don't you dare touch the inside. But then you have to take the derivative of the inside. Oh, sweet. I'm not going to plug in a 0 yet because spling, spling. Now if I plug in a 0, I get a 1 on the top. And on the bottom, I get secant squared of 0. Well, secant of 0. Well, that's just the reciprocal of cosine. And cosine 0, 1 over 1. Oh, sweet. If cosine's 1, secant is 1, right, class? Which means you get an answer of 1, and that guy's done, and I did LHOP beautifully. And you should actually make sure you say in the problem that you are using L'Hopital's rule, okay? So make sure you state that in your solution guide also, all right? And that's it. Nice and easy Japanese. I don't know about you, but these two problems, I feel, were more okay than the two problems we did the other day. Now, let's check and see how we actually scored. Let's see if you did your slope field right. Right, and the important thing here would be the slope fields that are 0, okay? And you would have slope fields that are 0 when y is 1 and when x is 0. And then you have your other slope fields, okay? Like I said, part C is going to be worth more points would be my expectation, okay, because part C is where you separate, integrate, and then you've got to, like that one I thought was very, very okay. All right, so I'm thinking this should have been an 8, 9, or 10 for all of us at home. Maybe the like relative maximum one could have been a little bit tougher, but hey, work on those weaknesses that you have, and you guys will dominate these. Aloha, it's a Sunday, it's beautiful out. We went and watched church on TV earlier. We're going to go out and play right now. Judgment week, I hope you guys dominate it. Make sure you're sending me these guys, and I will see you at Google Meets.